From Science Magic Platform. Today I am here to discuss lesson number 1, class 6, CBSE. Food, where does it come from? This is the first lesson. Today I am giving only the introductory part. First, we should know what is food mean. Food means some nutritious substance which is required for our body for proper growth, maintenance, repairing the damaged cells, to fight diseases and to get energy. These are the main uses of eating food. The sources of food are plants and animals. So what is the source means? From where you are getting this food, that is called source. So we are getting food from plants or animals. This food contains carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, water and roughage. So these are the main nutrients present in food. So carbohydrates and fats which are required for getting energy. Carbohydrate means instant energy like glucose. Fats are stored form of energy. Whenever it is required, it will be providing instant energy after converting it into the form of glucose. Proteins, it is for growth, and even minerals are for growth. Vitamins to fight the disease. Whenever we are getting any infection by bacteria or fungus or by virus, any antigen containing bodies, it will be supporting our body by producing antibodies to fight against this foreign particles which is trying to enter your body. Then water and roughage, these we cannot consider as nutrients, but this is part of the nutrients because for proper digestion, for the proper circulation of all the nutrients through our body and to supply to the organs, the water is very much essential. The roughage, what is roughage? It is called as dietary fiber. So this is also not a nutrient, but after digestion of the food, the undigested food which is not absorbed by the small intestine is pushed out, or by the process of ejection, it has to go out with the help of roughage. So you have to include this roughage in your diet in order to prevent constipation. So these are the nutrients present in food. So depends on the state or country, we have different types of staple food, different types of diet. So depends on that, we are following different types of food for breakfast, lunch and dinner. So the next is food item. What are the ingredients making this food item and from where does this come from? So all these three things we are going to see in this table. So first is food item. Second is ingredients. So what is ingredients means? So ingredients means the things what you are adding to make that food. So we cannot eat individually the items. We cannot eat it. It won't be tasty. So to make it tasty, we are adding all the nutrients in the correct proportion to make a food item to eat. That is called ingredients. So we have to put up all the ingredients together in correct proportion to make a food item. Then sources means from where we are getting these ingredients. It can be from plant origin or it can be from animal origin. So these are the three things we are going to see in this table. So once you know what are the ingredients making the food item, easily you can tell the source of this ingredients. So normally we are following all these things, all these food items, considering as breakfast. depends on North Indian food and South Indian food, the preference will be different. So the first one is roti or chapati. So roti and chapati depends on the diet of the person. Some are considering as breakfast food or lunch or dinner. So it depends on the person it is. So roti and chapati, what are the ingredients? So roti and chapati, the main part of this roti and chapati is wheat flour. So I should write here, wheat is the main ingredient making this chapati. Along with, I cannot use only wheat to make chapati. I should add salt. I should add water. Then, after making the chapati, to fry it, I should use some ghee or oil. So, these are the main ingredients to make chapati or roti. Then here, sources of all these ingredients. So sources means from where does these ingredients come. So here, wheat. Wheat, it is from plants. Then second is salt. Salt we are getting from sea water. Next is water. Water depends on the place we are living. Some are getting, if it is where we are staying in village, you'll be getting from well, or you're getting from river, or you're getting from tube well, or different sources of water are there. Then ghee or oil. So ghee means it is animal origin. If you're preferring ghee, you should write only animal source. Then oil. Oil means you can define here as a plant origin, because there are different types of oil we are using. Coconut oil, mustard oil, sunflower oil, all these are the types of oils we are preferring to make chapati. So here, this can be plant origin. I told you the reason, this can be plant origin if you are using oil. The second is idli or dosa. This is also from rice. So the we are mixing rice, plus we are adding water, plus urad dal, plus little bit salt. So all these things we are mixing in correct proportion to make idli or dosa. So this is a batter is prepared by using all these ingredients. So here also you can say rice. This is from a grass type of plant origin. Urad dal, this is also from plant origin. Salt from sea water. Then water from tube well or river or any other water source. The next is rava upma. Rava upma means here upma we are calling as suji rava. That is also a wheat type. Along with we are adding salt, sugar, then onion. All these are we are mixing to make a rava upma, and mustard seeds also. So once you are going through the ingredients, the cooking process is also very easy. So these are the things we are using to make rava upma. This is one of the healthiest breakfast. So wheat, plant origin, salt from seawater, sugar from sugarcane plant, that is plant origin, onion from plant, then mustard is also from plant. So here, like this, we have to characterize each ingredient and identify the type of the source. Can be plant source, can be animal source, can be from seawater like salt, or can be from water source. These are the main sources we are getting these ingredients. Then the next breakfast is puttu, and next is bread and cheese. All these are the types of breakfast we are using, and you should identify the types of ingredients and sources of all these types of breakfast food. Next, moving to the lunch items, rice. We cannot eat rice without any side dish. So we have to prefer dal curry or chicken curry. Depends on your vegetarian or non-vegetarian, the preference will be different. So dal curry, chicken curry, then sambar, vegetable curry, kheer. Kheer is one of the sweet. So here, rice, dal curry. For preparing rice, you should have rice, along with you should add water, little bit salt to make it tasty. So all these are the ingredients to prepare rice. Dal curry, you should have the pulse dal. You can write as DHAL or you can write as DIL. So dal, pulse you require. You should add some water, you should add some salt, you should add some turmeric. To get the taste, you can add some ghee also, ghee or oil. So these are the ingredients to make dal curry. Then chicken curry, the main ingredient will be chicken along with some spices, water, onion, then tomato, all these things we are mixing to make chicken curry. Then sambar, all the vegetables depends on the choice, along with some spices, coriander leaves, salt, water, all these are making the ingredients for sambar. Then kheer, rice, milk, sugar. So here what is the conclusion of this lesson is ingredients. Ingredients mean the substances which we are mixing in correct proportion to make a food item for breakfast or lunch or dinner are from different sources. Can be from plant source, can be from animal source, can be from seawater, can be from the what is the next one? Water source. So all these things we have to identify and categorize the food into different types of food items. So we cannot eat all these food items. Some people are diabetic, some are heart patients, some are following the diet prepared by their dietitian. So depends on that, only this much calorie food they should be having for breakfast or lunch or for dinner. So accordingly they have to manage the food and be healthy. So this is the first part of food. Where does it come from? Lesson number 1, class 6. Thank you.